Good morning, students. So today we learn some applications of linear equations. So according to question, you have to first make the equation, then it will be easy to solve. So first I will solve the example 5 given in page number 24 in your textbook. So example 5 is, what should be added to twice the rational number -7/3 to get 3/7. The first your given rational number is given rational number equal to this one -7/3. So twice means what? Two times. Twice of the number. -7/3 into 2. -14/3. Okay. Twice number means what? -14/3. So, given what should be added to twice the decimal number. So, what should solve? Let we add equal to x. You don't know what should be added. You don't know. So according to your question, suppose x is added to this. So x plus -14/3 equal to your 3/7. 3/7. Okay. So x equal to, this will go RH side to LH, LH side to RH side, and 3/7 plus 14/3. It is minus, it changes to plus. So your LCM 21, 7 3 is 3 is 9 plus 3 7 is 14 7 is 98. Okay, so it is 107/21. So 107/21 should be added to twice of the rational number to get 337. Example 6. The perimeter of a rectangle is 13 cm and its width is 3/4 cm. Find its length. So, perimeter, you know perimeter. Perimeter of a rectangle equal to 2 into length plus width. This is formula of a perimeter. And is given also, that is 13 cm. Okay, width equal to 2 3/4, mixed fraction is changed to improper, 2 4 8 plus 3 11/4 cm. Let length, okay, length you take x, because you don't know, you have to find the length. So now put this width and the length in this formula and you will get the equation to solve. The 2 into length is xm plus width, how much? 11/4 cm equal to 13 cm, it is given. So it is, you got the equation. Now you find the value of x. So x plus 11/4 cm equal to 2 is 2 multiplied here. So when it go that side, what will happen? Divide 13/2 cm. Okay, it will divide. Then x equal to 13/2 - 11/4. Okay, so LCM is 4. 2 2 is 13 2 is 26 - 11. That is 6 - 1. How much? 5. 15/4. Okay, now it's change it to this fraction. 4 3 is 12 3/4. This is the answer. The next example 7. D, little lengthy. The present age of Sahil's mother is 3 times the present age of Sahil. So, after 5 years, their age will be 8 to 66 years. So find the present age. You have to find the present age. That's all. The present age of Sahil's mother is 3 times the present age of Sahil. So let present age of Sahil. So present age of Sahil how much? Suppose x. So same. Present age of mother is 3 times of Sahil. 3 times means 3 into x, that is 3x. So present age x, present age 3x. Sahil age x, mother age 3x. So after 5 years, after 5 years means Sahil's age will increase 5 years, mother's age also increase to 5 years. So after 5 years, yes, Sahil's age will be, Sahil's age will be x plus 5. Mother's age, same thing, after 5 years, mother's age will be 3x plus 5. Present age 3x. 3x plus 5. But this is Sahil's after 5 years. This is mother's after 5 years. So here given, after 5 years, their age add 2. So after 5 years means x plus 5 plus 3x plus 5. So this is Sahil's age. This is mother's age. So after adding these 2 ages, here given, 66 years. Okay. So equal to, listen, after 5 years their age add 2. Add 2 means Sahil's age plus mother's age. So Sahil's age x plus 5, mother's age 3x plus, here 3x plus 5. So 66. Add x plus 3x. How much? 4x. 5 plus 5 is 10 years. Equal to 66. So 4x equal to 66 minus 10. How much? 56. Okay. Then x equal to 56 by 4. 4 1 the 4 4 the 16. So x. What is x? Present age is 14. So here given, what is the present age of mother and Sahil? So Sahil's age 14. So present age. Equal to 14. Mother equal to 3x, 3 into 42 years. Okay. So this is the answer. So next example 8. So try to understand carefully. So Bansi has 3 times as many 2 rupees coins as he has 5 rupee coins. So he has a 2 rupee coin and 1 2 rupees 5 rupee coins. Some 2 rupees coin, some 5 rupee coins. So if he has all a sum of 77 rupees, how many each denomination does he have? Denomination means how many 2 rupees coins, how many 5 rupees coins. Denomination means how many 2 rupees coins and how many 5 rupees coins add together, we get 77 rupees. So Bansi has 3 times, here first line, Bansi has 3 times as many 2 rupees coins as he has 5 rupees coins. Let number of 5 rupees coin equal to x. Okay. So number of 5 rupees coin x. Then number of 2 rupees coin equal to 3 times. 2 rupees coin is 3 times, that is 3x. number of 5 rupees coin, 3x number of 2 rupees coin. So, how much the amount? Amount means, suppose you will ask that you have a 5 2 rupees coin. So, how much? 2 5 is 10 rupees. Suppose you have asked 4 5 rupees coins. So, amount is 5 into 4. So, same thing, same procedure we will adopt here. So, if a 5 rupee coin x, then the amount or sum of money 1c h. So, 5 rupee x, so 5 into x equal to 5x rupees. 5 rupee coin, if you can write it, 5 rupees coin from 5 rupees coin he has, that is x into 5, that is 5x rupees. Okay, this is one. Number 2, from 2 rupees coin. So, 2 rupees is 3x number. Number of 3x coin is 3x. So, rupees 2. So, 3x into 2. That is 6x rupees. Okay. So, 3x rupees, 5x rupees, 3x rupees. So, total amount is your 77. Okay. You add together. So, 5x plus 6x equal to Rs 77. So, this was 11x. 11x equal to rupees 77. Then, x equal to 77 by 11, that is 7. So, x equal to 7. The number of 5 rupees coins. So, here given, number of 5 rupees. Again, so, number of 5 rupees coin is x, that is 7. Okay. Number of 2 rupees coin, 3x, that is 7 into 3, 21. Okay. So, number of coin. So, number of coin is 7. 2 rupees coin is 21. So, this is your answer. So, amount. How will you check amount? So, here 5 means 7 into 5, 35 rupees. Then here what? 21 coins. So, 21 into 2 rupees coin. 2 1 2 2 3 4, total 77 rupees you got. So your answer, so denomination means for 77 rupees how many 5 rupees coin needed? 7. And how many 2 rupees coin needed? 21. So this is your answer. Next example 9. So the sum of 3 consecutive multiples of 11 is 363. Find the multiples. So, multiple means what? 11's multiple. Suppose you find 11's multiple. 11 1 is 11. 11 2 is 22. 11 3 is 33. These are the multiples of 11. Okay. That means, first if 11, next is 11 plus 11, 22. Second is 22 plus again 11, 33. Then next will be 33 plus 11, 44, like this. So, just I remind you what is multiple. So, here given, this sum of 3 consecutive. Consecutive means serial number. Suppose 11, next consecutive 22, then 33, then 44, then 55, like this, 66. So, these are consecutive. Okay. So, what are the 3 consecutive numbers? You don't know. You have to find out. So, this given, the sum of 3 consecutive multiples of 11 is 363. So, find this. So, let solution. First multiple equal to x. Okay. So, second consecutive, next multiple, next second you don't have, next multiple, x plus 11, I told you first one, then cross 11, like this, then next multiple, equal to x plus 11. Again, plus 11, x plus 22. Understood na? Serial number. Serial number, when you put the number line, it is first is 11, x will be 22, x will be 33, next will be 44, like this. So, plus 11, plus ho ke gaya. So, they are the consecutive. So, first if 11, next consecutive is plus 11, next consecutive is again you add 11. This. So, these three numbers when you add, you get 363. So, what you do? X plus 11 plus x plus 22. This number, this number, this number. Add, you get 363. Understood? So, first multiple, these are three consecutive multiples. X plus 11, x plus 22. And their answer, they are given, that is 363. So, add this. X open, x plus 11 plus 11 plus x plus 22 equal to 362. So, very important in this problem, you just make first the equations. So, x, 3x and then x, then this is what? 33, 11 plus 22, 363. 3x equal to 363 minus 33. This came, this plus, that came to RHS. Minus 33, that is 3 minus 3 is 0, 6 minus 3, how much 3? Now that is 300, how much 30. So, x equal to 330 by 3. That is 310 is your first multiple. So, first x equal to 110. Then x plus 11 equal to 110. Plus 11, that is 1, 2, 1. Then third is x plus 22. This one, so 110 plus 22, 2, 1, 3, 1. So 110, 100, how much? 21, 132. So these are the consecutive multiples which sum is 300. So next example, 10. The difference between two whole number is 66, and the ratio of the numbers is 2:3. So what are the numbers? So difference given, 66 difference means subtraction, and the ratio given. So solution. So ratio of two numbers. That is 2:3. So let the numbers. So we take x na. So here 2:3 means you will take 2x:3x. 2 times 3 times. x:2 means what? 2 times 3 times. So x is 2 times, x is 3 times. So here given difference. The difference between two whole number is 66. So it is one whole number, it is another whole number. So difference means 3x minus 2x equal to given 66. That is 3x minus 2x equal to how much? So total, it is not a question wrong, you get. So 2:2, it is 5. So it is 2:5, that means 2x 5x. Understood? So difference between here how much? 5x minus 2x. So 5x minus 2x equal to 3x equal to 66. So x equal to 66 by 3. 3 to the x equal to 22. So x equal 22 means here first number is 2x, second number is 5x. So first number equal to 2x, that means 22 into 2, that is 44. Okay. Then second number equal to 5x. So 5x equal to equal to 22 into 5, that is 5 to 10, 5 to 10, 110. So here what, 44, 102 numbers you get. So according to question here given, difference between the number is 66. So let's check. Suppose 110 minus 44. So 10 6, a 6. So your two numbers are 44 and 110. So this is all about today's class. I have completed many examples, solved it, and you try to understand. And another example 11, I will discuss it in next class. And also many problems, exercises also 2.2 is 16 problems. So you try to solve and you can place your doubts. So thank you.